lifestyle entrepreneur and the host of the Mommy Millionaire podcast. And she's here today with her new book, The Habit of Leading Yourself, a one-year guide to becoming unstoppable. We love this. Please welcome Kayla Kraft to our home. Welcome, Kayla. So your book promises to teach us all how to become unstoppable in our family lives and personal lives, as well as our business lives. How so?
Because most of us are a slave to our habits, right? And most of us are just a slave to bad habits. Mm. And so I want to teach people how we can implement good habits into our lives so that way we're a slave to good things and we, like, dominate our lives.
And they drive.
Yes.
Yeah, because habits, I mean, it really is.
Well, it's easy to fall into bad habits, too.
But in order to kind of do that, you say that we've got to kind of clear the slate, right? We've got to, and in order to do that, you say we need to take a break from media. Now, you're talking about, like, all media?
Does that make you nervous? Just for, like, a day. We can handle it.
Just for a day.
Huh. So, what if you work in media?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, no, but tell us about that and why that's important, really.
So the book starts out with a detox, and it's not just with your body, it's with your mind. And we consume so much on a daily basis, scrolling social media, you know, looking and checking our phone on text messages. Just there's so much that we're consuming, we need to start creating, right? And we need to, like, focus on our thoughts and what do we think about things and not just be so easily influenced by other people.
As you can see, Paige and Orly are joining us here because we would
interested.
We'd all, if that means becoming a mommy millionaire, Cameron would like to be a mommy millionaire.
I'm right here.
I see nothing wrong with that.
And I know we all have some questions. Yes. So let me start with you, Paige.
Well, you talk about defining values, and I always think about that, like, when I'm asked to take a job or asked to do something, especially right now, like, what does it align with what I want? Or, but I don't know how to, I guess I don't really know what that means. Is, like, completely separating? Do I say no to everything? Do I say no once? I'm not good at saying no. But what do I do to make sure that my values are taken care of?
Mm-hmm. Well, you have to be very clear on what they are. So, for instance, mine are, you know, faith, family, fitness, and friends. Mm-hmm. It's very easy to remember. And so the most successful people in the world, they make quick decisions. Mm-hmm. So if you could just think right now, like, what are some of your core values?
Staying home.
Okay.
Being with my family.
So family is a core value. And so it's easy to say no if it cuts into precious time with your family. And you just don't overthink.
I need to make a call.
Sorry, everybody.
You literally just made a life-changing decision for her right here in this segment.
Listen, you said quick decisions. You know what I mean? There it is.
There's always a way to get what you want.
Orly, I know you got a question as well.
Yeah, so you talk a little bit about, like, your money mindset. So when I think about money, I think of the things that were instilled in me by, like, my parents, right? So my parents worked really hard. My dad always told me, like, if you work hard enough, no matter how hard it is, you can have what you want. You have to be willing to work for it and always to have, like, balance. Like, don't spend more than you make, you know, like, live within your means. Is that my money mindset? And if so, is that healthy? Any tips to create, like, a healthier mindset?
Absolutely. So we all have a financial blueprint. And I grew up, I was actually raised by a single mom. My dad was in jail. And she declared bankruptcy when I was 7 years old. And so imagine my blueprint now to be the mommy millionaire. And I had all these things, like, money doesn't grow on trees. Like, money will never make you happy. Right. And those were things I had to evaluate and say, do I really believe the things I've been telling myself for years?
Right.
And so I always ask people, you know, take an inventory of what your parents told you, what your grandparents told you growing up. And you can see right there, those are your money beliefs, and ask yourself, do I believe that? And then if you don't, you know, think things that serve you and where you want to go. So I have this really fun challenge. It's actually in my book, and I have people hide cash all over the house. And then
I come over?
Yes.
Yeah.
Let's go. I only do it with dollar bills. Oh. But what it does is it shows your kids and you that money is everywhere. You just have to look for it. And you train your mind to think, hey, there's opportunity everywhere for me. It's so easy to make money. If you tell yourself that on a daily basis, all of a sudden it's like, oh, my gosh, opportunities are all over the place.
Oh, I love that.
You feel empowered to go get what you want.
I mean, there's so many great insights, and I know in your book there's so much more. I want to go back to the reset here for a second. We touched on it briefly, but it just came up for me. Something that came up was that as far as my kids and social media and myself, you know, working in media, the best vacation that I've ever done with my family wasn't even intentional, was up in the Sequoia Mountains, and there was no reception. We had no screens whatsoever. And the amount of productivity, the creativity that came out of my children, my family, on this vacation without even trying to do it was amazing. thing. All of a sudden, like sticks and rocks in the forest and trees became like everything. And then it was the ultimate best vacation for us. There's a lot to that reset, that like stepping back and developing, allowing the new habits to happen.
Yeah.
Would you say that's true?
Yeah. And I think once you get the junk out, you make space for the good things. Right?
Yeah.
You make space for what you really want. A lot of people, they're just going through their days doing the same thing over and over again. And you know what the definition of insanity is?
Yeah. Yeah.
Doing the same thing over and over again.
Expecting a different result.
Yes. Exactly. Yeah. And so you have to shift it up and you have to decide, what do I want at the end of this year? And then decide who that person is and go and make actions every single day that that person takes.
You said something to Paige about her, what are your core values, and that'll help you make your decision. What if there's too much noise with the social media and with everything else for you to even figure out what that is?
Yeah. Right. So I think that's when you have to get quiet. I call and tell people to do a brain dump. So the people that I'm coaching, I know, you guys are like, what is this about?
No.
Okay.
Sounds amazing.
First thing in the morning, you wake up, you have all these thoughts racing through your head, and sometimes it doesn't even make sense. And so I challenge everybody in the book, as soon as you wake up, grab a journal next to your nightstand and write everything that's in your mind. Get super clear so that way you can have clarity on where you're going throughout the day.
That's great advice.
That's so good.
As opposed to picking up your phone and looking at Instagram.
That's the worst
thing. How about a pen and a paper?
Yeah.
That's what you used to do.
Yep.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Kayla.
And congratulations, Paige, on solving
that
problem right here.
Wow.
The Habit of Leading Yourself is available on Amazon, and you can find more information about Kayla on her website.
Absolutely. Coming up next is Allie.
All right, if you have a little kiddo that runs the other way when you try to get them to wash their hands, well, I have the cutest DIY soap dispenser that will have them running back the other direction and right to the sink.